Hello, everyone. Welcome back again. I hope you've been enjoying these Thursday night worship devotionals that we've been doing. It's just a real honor to be able to do life with you. If you're not on Facebook, just want to let you know these videos are available on our website, canarychurchofgod.com. And we have a YouTube channel as well, Canary Church of God, KCOG. And you can find all of our messages and these worship devotionals there. Tonight, before I sing, I just want to give you a little bit of a preface to where we're going in this worship time. This is going to be a time of just soaking in the Lord's presence and allowing Him to minister to us. There's a few things that we don't talk about, and when I say we, I'm speaking generally, that many churches do not talk about very much anymore. One of those things is sin. Sin is the thing that we've all done. Sin is the thing that separates us from a holy God. And unless we address that problem, we cannot come into His presence and we can't enjoy that intimate fellowship with Him. The other thing that we don't hear being spoken about as much as we did back in the good old days is the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. In our Western culture, we think of blood as symbolizing death. Something had to die or was wounded when we see blood. But in the Eastern culture, blood represents life. And even like with our First Nations peoples, they have a great reverence and respect for the blood of any animals that are killed for the sake of feeding their families. They don't take it lightly that that animal sacrificed its life to give them sustenance. We need to talk about the blood of Jesus because the blood of Jesus is the only thing that can cleanse us from our sins, and the wounds of Jesus bring us healing in our inward being as well as in our outward bodies. The last thing that I want to mention that we don't hear spoken about very often in many churches is the person of the Holy Spirit. He is the third person of the Godhead. And while we may assent intellectually and acknowledge, yes, we believe in the Holy Spirit, we really don't experience that intimate fellowship and relationship with Him. And apart from Him, we can do nothing. Jeremiah was a prophet to early Israel, and he wrote this in chapter 2, verses 12 through 14, and I'm reading from the Amplified Version of the Bible. Jeremiah writes, prophesying the word of God, "Be appalled, O heavens, at this. Be shocked and shudder with horror at the behavior of the people, says the Lord. For my people have committed two evils. They have abandoned or rejected me, the fountain of living water, and they have carved out their own cisterns, broken cisterns that cannot hold water." God is appalled and He's shocked, and He's like, my people whom I've left, I've called by my name, you've done two things that are unbelievable. You've rejected me and you've turned to the gods which are no gods of the pagan nations around you, and you're committing the terrible sins like child sacrifice and terrible orgies and just things that were unimaginable. He says, you've done that, you've rejected me, and you've gone to that. But he says, you've done something else, is you've carved out cisterns for yourself. You've rejected me, the fountain of living water. And you've gone and you've carved out little pots for yourself. But here's the thing about your pots. They're cracked. They don't even hold water. And I think there's many people today, we search for meaning, we search for significance and contentment and joy and happiness in many broken pots that don't hold water. They can't sustain joy and peace and contentment in our lives. Isaiah is another prophet. And in Isaiah 55, verse 1, God says this to His people, "Everyone who thirsts, come to the waters. And you who have no money, come. buy grain and eat. Come, buy wine and milk without money and without cost, simply accept it as a gift from God. Salvation is something that can only be received from God's hand. We can't earn it. We can't buy it. We just have to accept from Him. In John chapter 7, verses 37 through 39, Jesus said this. Now on the last day, the great day of the feast, Jesus stood and cried out, saying, "If anyone is thirsty, let him come to me and drink. He who believes in me, as the scripture said, from his inmost being will flow rivers of living water." But this he spoke of the Holy Spirit, whom those who believed in him were to receive, for the Spirit was not yet given, because Jesus was not yet glorified. Jesus says, if anyone is thirsty, let him come to me and drink. And if he does that and believes in me, out of his inmost being will flow the river of the Holy Spirit, who not only cleanses, he restores us, he revives us, he heals us, he draws us close to our bridegroom Jesus' heart, and he draws us close to the heart of the Father. So as I sing this song, At the Cross, we all need to come to the cross to have our sins forgiven and to receive the life that Jesus desires to give us.
Tore the veil.
Songs that I'm going to sing them together. I just want to flow tonight in worship. I don't want to say too much in between, except to say, when you have a thirst that you can't satisfy, it's just so terrible. It's heartbreaking to see people who are searching for love in all the wrong places. They become their own worst enemy. And as much as they want to change, they just don't have the strength, the wherewithal to do it. They need others to come alongside of them, and even more than that, they need the power of the living God to deliver them from that power of sin and death that pulls us down, that mires us in that quicksand. These last two songs are entitled, the first one is All Who Are Thirsty, and the last one is Let Your Healing Love. And the last song is especially, it has a special place in my heart, because I remember at one time our family was going through an extremely devastating season. And there were things that were happening that were beyond our control. Family members that were doing things that were breaking our hearts. And I remember sitting with one of the family members and listening to this song in a living room, not in a church, in a living room, listening to this song as it was playing on the CD player. And we just began weeping, and singing along with his song. Let your healing love pour over this place, soothe the wounded soul. I know that there are some of you who are watching and you feel like you're at a dead end. You have no power to help yourself. Help is on the way. Help is here. His name is the Holy Spirit. His name is Jesus Christ. He loves you so very much. And as I sing these songs, I just invite you to open up your heart to the great physician who alone can heal those deep, deep wounds, who alone can release you and deliver you from the bondage that you find yourself in. I'm going to believe along with you that God is going to touch you right where you are tonight, or whenever this is that you're watching.
dip your heart in the stream of life. Let the pain and the sorrow be washed away in the waves of His mercy. His deep cries up to let your healing love pour over this place. Make your people, oh, make us whole. Make your people, make us whole. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. Lord, what the world needs now is love. What the world needs now is your joy. What we need now, Lord, is your peace. We need your grace. We need your mercy, Lord. Is your love, Lord, your sweet unfailing love, your steady unwavering love, Lord. Oh, we need you, Jesus. We need you, Father. We need you, Holy Spirit. Come and move and touch hearts, break chains. Oh, lift the yoke of oppression, Lord. Lift our hearts, lift our hands. Be the glory, the glory, the lifter of our hands. We need you, Lord. We need you, Lord. We need you, Lord. So let your healing love, oh, pour over this place, every place. Soothe the wounded soul. Oh, let your healing love pour over every place, Lord. Make your people whole. Oh, Lord. Make your people. Make your people.
Thank you, Lord. May it be.